Hello friends, how are you? This is Rick Serrano. So I'm gonna show you, we are trying to make a reproduction. We need to give a birthday present and we're trying to make a reproduction of a painting by Rufino Tamayo, you know, one of my favorite painters. And this is the guy, Rufino Tamayo. And we are in the process of creating a couple of watermelons. You probably know from Tamayo. He's very famous for his watermelons, which is a typical Mexican thing. So basically we have selected the painting from many that we could do. We have selected one that we like. And initially, you know, this is a painting. So initially you can think this is pretty simple. And it's very easy to paint, actually. That would be the initial thought. But it turns out that there is a lot of geometry in this one. And I have now passed it to the white canvas. It's all a matter of, you know, with the rulers, finding the places where everything starts. Well, it looks very simple. Let me show you once again. Here it is, no? And let me show you where you need to begin to pass this to the canvas. So, because what might look like simple forms is actually full of geometry. So we're gonna start at the top, creating that band that extends on the top of it. You see that dark band, and then we will go to the lower parts. Let me see if I can show you, because it's a little bit difficult with the light, but let me show you. So fundamentally the lines will go, you need to determine that there's a diagonal that runs from northeast to southwest. You see there's a diagonal that will determine the whole thing. Then out of that, the horizontal section is divided in 7 segments, so you need to figure out the proportion, so it's 7 segments. And you're gonna have 3 segments on the right-hand side, 3 segments on the left-hand side, and then there's a band, an invisible band we cannot see. So if we go to the painting, you don't see the central part, you don't see the central band, but actually, if you concentrate very well, you do see it because it's there, you see? So you're gonna start by, first of all, identifying the top and the bottom dark. Then you're gonna draw the diagonal that we can see here in the middle. Mm-hmm. That one there, let me show you, okay? And then from there, you're gonna find the 7 segments that horizontally run from left to right, and you're gonna take 3 segments here. So that's 21 centimeters on this side. Then you're gonna have 21, 7 and 21. Then you're gonna go downwards, mm-hmm. And then exactly at the middle of the diagonal, we're gonna build this sort of leaf here. Well, it's actually a piece of watermelon. But before you do that, once you have built the internal blind line, so let me show you once again, that internal blind line, you will identify that it automatically defines how big the first slides of the watermelons will be. Because the first slides of the watermelon will be this high, exactly where the diagonal, let me show you, exactly where the diagonal touches the vertical invisible section. So exactly where the diagonal, which is running northeast to southwest, exactly where it touches the invisible diagonal, there is it that you're gonna build the first triangle. I don't know if you can see it here, but there's the first triangle. Then you're gonna have the same exactly below here. And then exactly on the middle of this side of the triangle, so you can measure it, of course. So you will see it is 19 centimeters, that vertical. Exactly in the middle, you're gonna draw the line that will be the lower part of the watermelon. And then from there, it's very simple because you find the middle of the watermelon, and then from the middle of the watermelon, you need to put a vertical, right? And at the vertical, you find this point, which coincides with, it's not that you invented, of course, it coincides, or it must coincide with the first triangles, peak going in parallel to the side of the canvas, and it should be exactly the half of that. So approximately 16 centimeters here. Then you have your highest point, and then you simply draw the curve of the other watermelon. And you're gonna do exactly the same for the other watermelon here. And then you finally are going to do the same for the central part of the watermelon. So that is all the geometry that we use to build this kind of watermelons that you might think they are pretty simple, but they are not. There's, of course, as we have seen, a lot of geometry involved, and there's a lot of lines that you don't see firsthand, but that exist in there. So the same goes, of course, for many of the works of Tamayo, but especially the watermelons, as we have seen. So this is the canvas before the color. So we will go back later to show you the color. Thank you. So hello again. We are a little bit further. As you can see, we have put more reddish onto the watermelons, onto the first two watermelons, and the other ones have now the pink is drying out. So remember, it's yellow, then pink, and then orange or red that will give us eventually the color of the watermelons. Now we're gonna put a base. We need to have on these other triangles and figures, we need to have a warmer red. So again, we're going to build a base of yellow, and we will start. So again, we go with the light yellow just as the basis for the whole thing. You want to go quickly, swiftly through the canvas, you're just trying to make the basis of what will be later a very warm red. that we need some yellow below them. So you can see it's a lot of fun, again, because the colors are relatively liquid, so you can play around with them. Just we're just putting light. This is like gonna be like bottom light. You see, then everything starts to turn warmer. You don't want to leave anything white. You want to have the whole base is making the whole painting warm. We're always starting with the lighter colors and leaving the dark ones, so the browns and the blacks for the end. You first, because it's acrylic, you cannot cover what you have already done, so you want to start with the light colors. And again, enjoy. We will come back. Hi, now we're making the reddish red, so we're gonna keep going with the reds. We have, as you can see, the yellow bed behind, and now it's become warmer. The whole thing is coming, it's becoming warmer, and we continue with the fast-paced painting. We will simply stop a little bit when it comes to doing the edges of the watermelon. And then we're gonna try to burn a little bit this red, which is very vivid now. But we're gonna put a little bit of dark brown to give some tones of ochre and like copper a little bit on what you see now as a vivid red. But we will come for that a little bit later. Bye-bye. So now we're adding a little bit of copper, you can tell. Hi, so now we have added the purple, like pink purple for the watermelons and the watermelon slides. And now we're gonna go ahead and try to finish the warm red on the sides, which as you see, it has a little bit of ochre now. And then we will do the profiles and then a little bit of green here. And then finally, we're gonna close with this part here and the sides. We'll be back. Hello again. So it is already night here. We've been painting the whole day, but we are now getting to the dark colors. So now comes the dark red, dark ochre here. And also on this part, we're gonna put the dark here all over the place. It's like a combination between a deep purple and a dark shadow brown. So, by the way, we are also painting the sides of the painting. in case the client doesn't want to spend in the frame. So that makes it substantially less expensive, of course, and it decorates very nicely. Un poco. No, hace frío. So now we are ready to put in the green for the watermelons, and we have prepared combining these two tones of green. Maybe I need a little bit darker green. Let's see. I'm gonna put just a bit. This is again too liquid for my taste, but still we're gonna try to make it work. Was it that too much? Yeah, that was a little bit too much, so let me put a little bit clear. Just like that, a lighter green, and then we're gonna work on it. It's really too liquid for my taste, but still, as you can see, it does resemble the green of the watermelons. So we're gonna try with this. Let's see. Now, so we need very, very thin brush for this. And let's go. You need to feel it, just like, just feel it. So yeah, not, shouldn't be perfect, should be just like a line. Should be just a bit, maybe take more color. Definitely we can make this darker. So we're gonna come back with more darker green. So we're basically finished, basically done. We're just gonna sign it now. Gonna sign it and then it's gonna be over. Finally, we are going to sign it. We need to verify that it's fine enough. Yeah. Hi, so now it's finished. We have put the signature, and we have also put the signature of Tamayo, the original, with both years. And then we're gonna hang it on the wall so that you can see how it looks when it will be on the wall. So, basically that's it. We have finished several hours, but it's, yeah, probably it will make a nice gift. Thank you very much. Take care.